darkness because he had been in true light, pure light, God. The more time you spend in the presence of God, the more you begin to walk just like that. When I went and finally went to that conference, that I had 15 whole minutes. The first thing the Lord showed me in that vision was this. I was sitting there, this Bible was new at that time 3 years ago, and I'm thinking, okay, what's that? I never get direction this way. This is not who I am. But I threw open the Bible, and I looked down, and it was at Mark 9, the Mount of Transfiguration. And immediately the Lord said, you know, you can do this by faith. Well, isn't that how Jesus did everything? By faith? So he took Peter, James, and John up on the mountain. And by faith, he began to release that inner light, that luminous, that who he truly was. And it changed the atmosphere and it removed the veil between two realms. Y'all want visions? Y'all want to see God face to face? Release the light. That's all he did. He stepped into the fullness, or began to step into the fullness of who he truly was as a man on this earth. The Lord said, you can do this by faith anytime you want. I closed the Bible and meditating on that. I'm like, DK. I said, Lord, forgive me. I need one more. I threw the Bible open again. I said, I don't do this. Timothy, I have not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and love and a sound mind. He said, this is by grace and grace alone. And I said, okay, Lord, what do you want me to share tonight? He said, just what you experienced in this time with me. I said, okay. Put the Bible away. I'm good. Don't have to come up with one point in the close. So I got to this meeting. They had congressmen and senators and mayors and, you know, they had a program. And the pastor came up during worship. He said, now, remember, you got 15 minutes. We got quite a program tonight. I said, okay, 15 minutes. And then when the worship's over, he hands me the mic. Then I time myself. I'm under authority. Okay. It took me 9 minutes. I keep reminding him he owes me 6 minutes. And in that 9 minutes, I shared about the experience and all of this. And the manifest presence of God came into that room. To everybody was standing there going, even the unsaved, the congress, you know, these people, the senator. And the pastor sneaks up and he says, whatever God tells you to do, do it. I said, I did here. And he stood there like a deer in the headlights going, okay, let's go back to the program. I went, ah. And I rebuked him afterwards. I said, when the presence of God is there, you throw that stupid program out the window. Stop thwarting what God wants to do. I don't care if the president of the... Who cares? The king of the universe is there. And the Lord said, see, I can do more in a minute than you could do in a lifetime. He said, now you walk in this light. Walk in this light. Moses spent so much time in the presence of God that his skin changed and began to glow. He did this under a lesser covenant. He had an external encounter, a touch, an occasional visitation. You have the indwelling of this light. What he knew in part, you have the fullness of the Godhead dwelling within you. We keep grasping at straws and going, oh, I want this and I want that. Give me more, give me more. He's got no more to give you because he already gave you everything he is. It's in you. It's time to let him out. It's time to recognize who you are and agree with God instead of agreeing with the tree of knowledge of good and evil. I got to figure this out. Give me 27 steps. I can do that. I want rocket science. No, you want simplicity. His name is Jesus. Yeah. Let him loose in your mortal body. Father, I am